from the ladies, then leaving the words of the sad country song. My heroes have always been cowboys.
This is Mike Bruton, and he's a former Lakesider. And he was born and raised pretty much at Lakeside. And this is his wife. What was her name?
Ginger.
Ginger. And they have brought this wonderful metal statue down from their home. And they're donating it to Lakeside. And this is Mike's tribute to his father, Ben Bruton, who was considered to be the leader of bringing rodeo back to Lakeside back in the 60s. It was his idea, and some of his cronies had a lot to do with bringing it back because it had been gone from Lakeside for over a decade.
A friend of mine called me, and he's Bobby Unser Jr., the race car driver's son. And he said he had a statue that he was going to have to let go of, and he asked me to come look at this. And I came, when I saw it, I said, man, I said, if there's anything that says Lakeside Rodeo, it was this. And so we purchased it, and we would hope to donate it to either the rodeo or to the city of Lakeside. And hopefully, between yourself and Billy Ortiz, you guys made this wonderful moment happen for the city of Lakeside, town of Lakeside. Yeah. And we just think it says, everything about it says Lakeside Rodeo. Uh-huh. And that's why we liked it. So we got it for you guys.
There in Lakeside.
My dad owned a business in Lakeside. He was an electrician for years, and every spare moment he wasn't going to a roping or doing his electrician job, he put in a lot of the freeway lighting all around San Diego and all the way to L.A. and back. Every moment was spent at that arena, and we had the temporary arenas for years. I remember the first one when we dissed it was behind the Linda Lanes. And then we moved it over, when they moved it over to that plot of land where it was donated to them. And a lot of people, the Hostetlers, Charlie Perkins, just a lot of people that worked day in and day out to make that all happen. Sometimes people forget about them folks. And we thought this would be a good tribute, not just to my dad, but to everybody. All the folks that worked so hard to make the Lakeside Rodeo what it was and what it is today. I mean, it's a great event, and it was the biggest IRA rodeo in the country. For years. It's a good PRCA rodeo now, but boy, it was the granddaddy of IRA rodeos back when Dad was there.
High school, right?
They were trying to get funds to build a stadium. And Art Sattler, I can't remember all the names, but there was Mr. Sattler and there was a bunch of others back then, and the Hostetlers and some people that were all working together to try and figure out the best way to make some funds to help build the stadium. And I remember that it wasn't just a slam dunk. I remember that because I remember many nights when my dad was wringing his hands saying, I don't know if we're going to make it. And then it kind of just started steamrolling. And then it got to be where it was two rodeos a year there for a while. And then they got the BR or the Bull Riders only. And boy, there was a lot of different factions. Even after I was gone, I just know that even when he quit roping and quit riding, and he trained another announcer, and he would still drive the old water truck around that arena and disc that arena. It was just basically, his way he looked at it, it was something he built and watched it grow up from like a small deal to a big deal. And it meant a lot to him. And so did Lakeside.
And behind Manzanita 4-H, we have the Lakeside Historical Society. The Lakeside Historical Society was founded in 1972. Riding in the half-mile-high farm carriage is Eileen Carinder and Edna Coons. Both are founding charter members of the Lakeside Historical Society and have lived in Lakeside for all their lives. They proudly want to celebrate their 100th birthday. Happy birthday, Edna and Eileen. Wow. Give it up for Edna and Eileen. They both were here when Lakeside was young. Edna and Eileen are being escorted by the Lakeside Historical Society riders, Gracie Sue Parrott, Tammy Boots Lakeside, Cindy Helms, and Melissa Mason. Also in tribute to the late Mr. Lakeside Rodeo, Mr. Ben Bruton, the Bruton family dedicated this bronc-busting statue to the Lakeside Historical Society. Mike Bruton and the family have graciously gifted the statue in honor of his late father, Ben Bruton, and the many members of the El Capitan Stadium Association who have for 50 years worked hard to keep the Lakeside Rodeo alive and well in our historic town of Lakeside, California, Rodeo Town, USA. Visit Lakeside Historical Society on Facebook.
There you go.
Edna is a star.
Ready?
for. That's pretty clever.
Yeah, isn't it pretty?
Yeah.
They were saying the parade.
Yeah, but I never seen the parade.
Oh, okay. Well, that's
how's this? Absolutely.
Super. Love it. Now.
Good evening, everybody. How's everybody doing today?
Good.
That's great. As you came in to the LHS church, I know you noticed the bronc riding statue. You all wondering where that came from?
Yes.
Okay, well, it's going to be permanent here. It was gifted to us from Mike Bruton and his wife Ginger. They live in Albuquerque, New Mexico. They thought how wonderful it would be to donate it to the Lakeside Rodeo and Lakeside Historical Society on the 50th anniversary of the rodeo. So the rodeo's been going for 50 years. So in 1964, how it got started was the Lakeside Stadium Association was looking for ways to raise money for the kids and to build a bigger stadium over there at El Capitan High School. So Mr. Ben Bruton, who was formerly known as Mr. Lakeside Rodeo, he decided that he would suggest to bring the rodeo back. It had been out of commission for several years. I don't know if anybody remembers the rodeo being over here on Channel Road.
Yeah.
And then it was a racetrack as well. But once it closed down, there was no more rodeo. And so Ben Bruton and his associates got together and came up with, let's have a rodeo to raise money for the kids. And that's how it all got started. So I have a little something to read from Mike. He says, if you know the Lakeside Rodeo, then you know nobody loved or lived this rodeo or town like Mr. Lakeside Rodeo, Ben Bruton. Anybody know Ben Bruton?
No.
Yes?
Okay. See a few hands there. All right. So in tribute to the 50th year anniversary, the Bruton family dedicates this statue to the Lakeside Historical Society to be proudly displayed in memory of the Lakeside Rodeo's great history and to remind people of the folks that worked so hard for the past 50 years to make it all happen and to keep it going. The Lakeside Historical Society is proud to dedicate this bronco riding statue to the memory of Mr. Lakeside Rodeo, Ben Bruton and his associates, and the good folks that are still working today to keep the rodeo going. Ben was a rodeo announcer for the Lakeside Rodeo and a hard-working supporter in the early years of the rodeo. Like I mentioned earlier, he would go set up the bleachers, he would set up the fences, he would get the chutes, he would get everything in order for the rodeo to make money, and they made money for the kids in Lakeside. So in tribute of the 50-year anniversary, the Bruton family has donated this fine artwork to Lakeside and the annual rodeo. And as old Ben would say, till we meet again, may the good Lord take a liking to you. And so I'm recording for his son, Ben Bruton's son, Mike Bruton, right now. So I would like to say thank you, Mike. Everybody appreciates here at Lakeside. There's a lot of people looking at it and talking about it. And I'm going to swing the camera around to show you who's here.
Thank you, Billy.
Your best days are gone. Picking up hookers instead of my pen, I let the words of my youth fade away. Old worn out saddles and old worn out memories with no one, no place to stay. My heroes have always been cowboys, and they still are, it seems. Sadly in search of and one step in back of themselves,
and the slow-moving dream.